Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalam ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa taslima kathira amma ba'd. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, all praises are due to him, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon all of his messengers from Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad. Brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, continuing from our first class last week, reminding ourselves of the title, the fortress basically in the storm, right? And giving the image of something that's well built or deeply rooted. And no matter if it's a hurricane or a tornado, or if it's, a bolt of lightning or whatever the case may be, that the structure stays firm, because we're always going to be challenged. And last week I had mentioned the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, where he had mentioned that yati ala nas zamanun, there was going to be a time where people are going to be, they're going to be patient. Asabiru ala dinihi, they're going to be patient upon their faith. Qal qabidi ala jamr, like the one who's holding on to a hot coal. And went into the details, right, about how challenging and how more apparent these different hadith are going to be as time goes on. Because when the Prophet ﷺ was stating it, there was some understanding, because they were living the struggle. But imagine the people who were in the time of Abu Bakr and Umar, or the time of the great Khalifa Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, rahimahullah, where it was considered the golden age of Islam and the Muslims, or after the time of the Prophet, peace be upon him. So they weren't faced with these certain challenges. So for them to be narrating